So my name is Tetsuo Kuniya, come from Okayama University. So today I would like to talk about the origin and the genetic disease of the Japanese black cattle in ASEAN, introduced by Dr. Osawa. So firstly, I will introduce breed of the beef cattle in Japan. We have four different breeds in Japan. One is, of course, Japanese black. This is the theme of today's workshop. This breed was established by cross between Japanese native cattle and several European breeds. Of course, they have very excellent meat quality. And also, we have a Japanese brown. This is something kind of a hybrid between Korean native cattle and Simmental breed. They have relatively large body size and good for grazing. And Japanese shorthorn, this is cross between shorthorn, originated from shorthorn, and Japanese original cattle, maybe come from the Mongolia or Siberia. And also Japanese, we have also Japanese poles. But the number of the Japanese poles is now significantly decreased. Among these four breeds of Japanese cattle, of course, Japanese black is most famous, most popular, popular cattle in Japan. They have very excellent marbling performance and very famous as worldwide. But however, as Dr. Osa mentioned, the increased situation of the inbreeding is very serious problem for breeding of this breed. Because strong demand for the meat quality, very small number of the sire with high performance for the meat quality is intensively used for the breeding. As consequently, inbreeding situation increasing the population, and finally, it resulted in an increased incident of the hereditary disorders. This is something very serious problem in a Japanese black cattle breeding. So I'll talk about the hereditary current situation and how to manage the hereditary disorder in the Japanese beef cattle. So this slide shows a list of the hereditary disorder reported in Japanese black cattle and also some of them are Japanese brown cattle. You can see here at least 13 genetic disorders, including blood coagulation factor deficiency, have been reported in a recent year. And most of these are inherited as autosomal single recessive manner. And among these hereditary disorders, particularly renal tubular dysplasia, this is also called Claudin 16 deficiency, and weak calf syndrome, IARS deficiency. Incident of these two disorders very high, and it arises a very serious economical loss in the animal industry in Japan. So I'll show you several examples of the hereditary disorder reported in a Japanese beef cattle. So this picture shows the affected calf of the renal tubular dysplasia, Claudin 16 deficiency. As you can see, this calf shows the affected animal shows growth retardation and diarrhea. And as you can see, this is a typical symptom, overgrowth of hoofs. And usually, these affected calves die within 8 months after birth by uremia caused by severe renal failures. And this table shows the number of affected animals in a small herd of the Japanese local population. As you can see, it started in 1990. And gradually increased the number of the affected calves. And finally, in 1995, more than 3% of the newborn calf died by this disorder. More than 3%. So why so high incident of the hereditary disorder appearing in Japan? This is apparently caused by highly inbreeding situation. This Tigers show typical pedigree of the affected animals. This is Sayae, and this Sayae is very famous high performance Sayae, AI Sayae. And unfortunately, this Sayae was carrier of this disorder. Then he produced many Sayae of next generation, as well as a lot of the dams. Then many affected calf has appeared cross between half-sibled son and daughter of the Sayae, or even a cross between Sayae with his granddaughter. Such highly inbreed situations are apparently main cause of the high incidence of this disorder. This is another example of the hereditary disorder in Japan, Chadwick-Higashi syndrome. This silver coat color calf is affected animal, and they have breeding tendency with excessive breeding at castration and frequency appearance of the hematomas. And so their breeding tendency of these affected animals apparent, but fortunately, clinical symptom of this disorder is relatively mild, and most of the affected animals survive until adult food. So this is another example. This is congenital malformation of the eyeball. As you can see, this is named multiple ocular defect. As you can see, completely disorganized small eyeball are observed. And this section of the eyeball, so you can see column-like structure, and there are no lens and no iris. Of course, they are completely blind. This is also another example. Anyway, this is clinical symptom not so much serious because only other abnormality observed in this disorder and they grow normally. But this impressive appearance of this disorder have serious negative impact on the breeding of the Japanese black cattle. So this is weak calf syndrome. This is one of the common cause of the newborn death of the Japanese black cattle. This is affected calf, deliver normally, but die in a few days after delivery with unknown reason. They have small body size and standing and suckling difficulty and higher susceptibility for the pneumonia and diarrhea. And recently, gene for responsible for this disease was identified as IARS gene. And this table shows the genotypes of the IARS gene in a weak calf. As you can see here, almost 30% of the weak calf is homozygous for CC, homozygous for mutation of IARS gene. This means that not all, but a significant part of the newborn death of Japanese beef cattle, Japanese black cattle, is caused by IARS deficiency. So the impact of this disorder on the animal industry is very apparent or very serious. So what is the cause of this hereditary disorder? Of course, this is genetic cause. And of course, that we have to prevent this kind of the hereditary disorder to produce the Japanese black cattle. So that purpose, identification of the cause of the gene is the first step to prevent the disorder. So I will show you how to identify the causative gene for the disorder in a case of the condrodysplasia dwarfism observed in not Japanese black. This is Japanese brown. This disorder. This is a patient of the affected animal of the condrodysplasia in a cattle, and you can see small short legs and joint abnormality. And this is a section of the long bone. And in a normal case, of course, there is clear growth plate in here. But affected animal partially disappeared and highly disorganized epithelial plate was observed. This is typical future of the chondral dysplasia in also human case and other animals. So this is chondral dysplasia of the cattle. So to identify gene for the chondral dysplasia, we collected the DNA samples from the pedigree of the affected animals and performed the whole genome linkage analysis to map the locus for the disorders. Then by linkage analysis, we found that the gene for the disorder located in the distal part of the chromosome 6. Then we construct precise physical map of the this critical region of the chromosome 6 and investigate all the gene located in this locus. And finally, we found one gene which could be responsible for this disorder. So by expression analysis of this gene, you can see this is Holmont insert hybridization of mouse embryo. Then you can see strong expression of this gene in a developing limb bud. It means this gene has some particular function in a limb formation. So this gene is strong candidate for the gene responsible bovine chondral dysplasia, and we name this gene for limbin. So limbin is a relatively large gene comprised of the 22 exons. And we sequenced all the sequence and compared with the nucleotide sequence with normal and affected animals. And finally found two different mutations in exon 11 and exon 15. One mutation is named type 1 mutation. It's substitution of two nucleotide to one nucleotide. It causes, of course, frame shift mutation. And another type 2 mutation is something unusual mutation. As you can see, affected animals have C2T substitution in exon 11 of this gene. But this substitution does not cause amino acid sequence changes. However, this a mutation create completely identical to the splicing donor site. So which is, means that abnormal splicing happens in affected animal, and as a result, three prime part of the exon 11 was deleted in affected animals. So both type 1 type and type 2 mutation apparently cause the changes of the amino acid sequence, and through proba it causes the loss of the function of the limbin gene. Then, to confirm that this gene is actually responsible for chondral dysplasia, we generate a knockout mouse for the limbin gene. This slide shows the phenotype of the limbin knockout mouse. As you can see, they have small body size, and in an embryo stage, they have short. Sorry, this is in Japanese word, but anyway, long bone of the legs is shorter than normal one compared with them, and also histological section of bone indicate the defect in a differentiation of the chondral site. Therefore, the mutation of limbin gene finally confirmed that gene responsible for bovine chondral dysplastic dwarfism. So interestingly, after we published that limbin gene is responsible for bovine chondral dysplasia, this gene was also found to be related to the human hereditary disorder. This is a patient of the human Ellis van Creveld syndrome. They show the short limb, polydactyly, as you can see the extra finger here, and malformation of the vein. And limbin, after we published the cattle result, another scientist identified that mutation in limbin genes in this patient. So this is a good example that research on the human cattle disorder is also contribute to the field of the human medicine. Anyway, So by attempt to identify the mutation of the responsible for these density disorder, almost all hereditary disorder in Japanese black cattle was identified for the causative gene. This is a list of the causative gene of the disease disorder and the type of mutation. So next one is how to of course it's most important matter is how to prevent the incident of this hereditary disorder. After we identify gene for this disorder, we can develop DNA-based genotyping test to identify carrier animals. Identification of the carrier is most important to prevent the recessive hereditary disorder. And based on this genotyping test, we can perform the breeding program to prevent the disorders. So this is example of the genotyping test for the hereditary disorder. As I mentioned, Chadwick-Higgins syndrome is breeding disorder observed in a Japanese black cat. In disorder, mutation of the A to G in a LYST gene is identified as a causative mutation. This mutation is missense mutation resulting in amino acid sequence change of the histidine to arginine. This mutation occurred in a FOC1 restriction enzyme site. Therefore, this mutation, amino acid substitution, easily examined by digestion of a PCR product by FOC1 restriction enzyme. This slide shows the result. As you can see, after digestion of the PCR product by FOC1 restriction enzyme, clearly normal animal, carrier animal, and affected animal was distinguished by length of the PCR fragment. So this DNA-based genotype test is effective method for the identify the carrier cattle. Finally, based on these genotyping tests, we can perform the breed. Japanese government decide a breeding program for management of these hereditary disorders in a Japanese cattle. This program is comprised of two policies. Firstly, first policy is genotyping all the sires. Governmental agencies genotype all the sires and release this information, which includes the name of the carrier sire. This is very important. Carrier sire to public, so that breeder can advise to avoid the mating of the carrier sire with dam of the possible carrier. By this policy, this program, incident of all these hereditary disorder observed in the Japanese cattle have now dramatically decreased. Almost no affected cows currently reported in recent years. Second one is restriction of the registration of the carriers. Wagyu Registry Association do not accept registration of the carrier as a new sire. Result of this policy, more frozen semen that is free from this hereditary disorder are supplied for the breeders. By this program, frequency of mutant gene in the Japanese black population are now gradually, not quick, but very slow, but now reducing for frequency of the mutant gene is now reducing. So this program is going so far very well, and I believe that in the future, all the mutant gene can be eliminated from the population of Japanese black cattle. So this is our goal, is to make Japanese black cattle for healthy breed. Thank you for your attention.